Hey guys, it's Shelby. Today, we have a lot to talk about. We're gonna cover a lot of things in this video. I just want you to hopefully, if you have clicked on this video, to listen through the entire thing and just hear me out. But first of all, I am making this video because I already made another video quite similar to this one, and you can go check that video out. I'll link it right here. Basically, it was a video where I talked about the misconceptions or misunderstandings or just things that are not so straightforward that have to do with the zero waste and or sustainability movement. I honestly anticipated that video doing shit, like that no one would be interested. And it's not one of my most popular videos by any means, but a lot of you in the comments really expressed that you enjoyed like discussing sustainability further than just the surface. And so I figured we'd make another video like that today. And it only seems appropriate that I make this video today because of what is happening in the United States. I was going to say our country, but obviously a lot of you don't live in the US. There is a lot going on in the United States as well as in my personal life. So this video is going to be rambly, but I ask again, please stick through it. First thing we need to talk about is obviously racial justice and the issues surrounding that in the United States today. I want to give tangible things that we can all do to actually help what is happening right now, as well as a bit of my perspective, because I think that that's how I know how to speak to people the most, is by helping people understand my perspective, and by doing so, hopefully making the things that I have to say or the knowledge that I can share easier to relate to. And hopefully, you know, if you haven't been thinking this way or if you needed a mental shift in any way, maybe the first few minutes of this video can be that for you. In the United States, racism is baked into our society, okay? That is something that I wholeheartedly, fully believe, and you couldn't convince me otherwise. I want to see societal, cultural, overall systemic change, and I can get behind that 100%. What I want to add to this conversation is that you do not necessarily have to go out and be a protester. You do not necessarily have to go out and do those things. It is very important that you vote for people who will represent the entire human race. Vote for people who will stand up for those who are marginalized in the United States. Those actions are very important. As an individual and as a decent and conscious person, I do think that we all have a duty to be aware, to read and listen to people who have a different lived experience than you, be aware of those things, understand their perspective, and stand up against injustices in those ways. And I've been doing my best not to put myself at the center of this discussion, because I know that's something that is being asked of white people at this time, not to center ourselves around this discussion. But I've also been told by many people in my personal life that I should speak from the best way I know how. And so I'm just gonna do it as respectfully as I can, because to be honest with you, I have grown up in a very racist area of the world. I mean, you guys know I live in the South. I was born and raised in the South. I was born and raised by people who were openly racist. We're not talking about microaggressions. We are talking about outright happy and okay with saying they believe that people of a different skin tone are lesser than of them, which means I have actively had to have conversations with those racist people on a normal basis. It has made for a lot of difficult and awkward conversations at the dinner table, but I'm happy to do it because I know it's what's right. I have been advocating for people of color as much as I could for as long as I could, to the best of my abilities in my everyday life, in the way that I vote, in the way that I go about the world, but I haven't done necessarily as good at doing that in the public and through my content. I think it's important to be able to look at ourselves and ask, I'm sitting here constantly advocating for the planet, but am I advocating equally for the people that I share this planet with? And I pride myself on making this an inclusive space where everyone feels welcome, but I will say that I could have been doing a better job all along of making myself an ally and actively discussing the issues at hand and providing solutions to those things as I have done in my everyday life. And I think I've done that because it's easier to focus on individual actions that I talk about in my videos than it is to focus on bigger picture things, things that are not tangible, that are distant, that take decades to overturn and change. And I think that that's why I tend to gravitate towards individual actions that we can take, because I think it makes it more relatable and more immediate. And that's what American society is built on, instant gratification and that sort of thing. But that does not excuse my kind of lack of talking about why these issues exist and advocating that we as people, you know, that care about the planet and obviously the people that we share it with, do more. With that being said, there are a lot of resources for you to check out in the description. I made a doc of all of my favorite Black creators, also creators of color. They're not all Black, but you should definitely check them out. I'm going to have books, podcasts, Netflix series, all of those sort of things to try to help you understand the Black experience, because the sustainability space is very white. And so I think in the least that if anything comes out of the unrest and civil protests that are happening around the world, we have a duty to at least educate ourselves on why it's happening and how an entire community of people feel frustrated enough to see like the absolute largest civil rights outcry that we've seen in almost the entire history of the United States. I also made a blog post of Black-owned businesses. I did a lot of research. I found a lot of really cool brands. I bought from quite a few of them to review, either maybe in a YouTube video or on my Instagram. Either way, make sure you stay tuned for that. And lastly, I have done my best to put as much money where my mouth is as possible. I have made a lot of donations to various organizations, and I'll have some of those linked below that you can donate to. But I have personally also made a website so that I can match your donations. So I'm personally choosing to use this video and all the proceeds from this video, including all the donations you guys choose to make, to go towards Campaign Zero. They use research, data-based evidence to advocate for change in police brutality and the overall system that we see today that has led to complete injustices. It's so much more than I can get into, but the way our society is structured, the jailing system, the policing system, all those things were built to oppress people of color. I'm going to be matching your donations to Campaign Zero, and all you need to do is go to Campaign Zero. I'll leave the link in the description. Go over there, make a donation, screenshot it, go to shellbizzle.com/donate, submit your screenshot, and I will match your donation to Campaign Zero, and we can just make a bigger impact that way. And like I said, I've already made contributions myself and will continue to do so, but I thought as a collective, we could make a difference if we did that. So yeah, all of that will be explained in the description, but it's the least I can do at this point. All right, well, that will lead us into our first misconception, so let's go over to that. First misconception I want to talk about is that sustainability is not only about ecosystems.
Okay.
Sustainability at its core has nothing to do with saving the planet, okay? The planet, it's gonna be here after humans. It was here long before us. We are essentially a virus that harms the planet, and it's going to outlive every single one of us. I virtually can guarantee it. What you and I are fighting for through sustainability is actually the ability to sustain ecosystems that humans rely on. The entire idea of sustainability is to sustain our resources so that humans can use them without completely depleting them. That's the whole idea of sustainability, okay? And you can't have that without worrying about the people of this planet and also the economic status of the people of this planet. So when I was in college, I worked for the Office of Sustainability for my university, and that's kind of when I solidified what I viewed or labeled as sustainability. And like I said earlier, I saw the three pillars that have to do with social, environment, and economic, and all of those things kind of have to be married together to make sustainable sense, because if it's incredibly expensive and doesn't make sense to the greater proportion of society, it's not going to be sustainable long-term, because people cannot care about the ecosystems that we rely on if they're worried about being able to put food on the table because of expenses. That's a very simplified version of explaining it, but that's an example. And same thing over here with social, has to do with like health and safety. And if people do not feel safe, and if they do not have their health intact, again, they have larger things to be concerned about than sustaining the environment. So you have to have all of these three things married to have a sustainable society. And I don't know if people talk about that as much. I only learned it because, like I said, my Office of Sustainability at Texas A&M is absolutely incredible. I thank them for so much of my perspective that I have today. But I don't see that talked about too often, and honestly, not for myself either. Again, because it seems like larger issues that are harder to educate people on how to make that change, but that doesn't mean that we should never talk about it. So yeah, that's the first misconception, that we are just trying to sustain the planet, sustain our ecosystems, when in reality, we are fighting for the ability for people to be able to remain on this planet and have resources that we rely on long-term. That is what we are sustaining. Misconception number two is that all zero-waste swaps are created stated equal. And we're moving away a little bit from the social justice here, but also to me, it's completely unethical to do the things we're about to talk about. So I see that as a social justice issue still. So if you go onto Amazon, oh, this is so frustrating, has been for a long time. There are plenty of different ways or different brands of silicone reusable bags, right? And I'm just using this as an example. There are a lot of brands, but if you guys didn't know, a lot of those brands are just what we label as drop shipped. Honestly, I personally believe there is one super high quality reusable silicone bag brand, and it's the first brand I had ever heard of, and they remain to be the best one, and it's Stasher. Always gonna stand behind Stasher. I have tried many brands, and Stasher remains the best one. Point being that there are a bunch of brands over that can just go and get large quantities made in China, stamp a logo on it, put it on Amazon, and sell it because of the way Amazon works. And if a brand has been able to drop ship something from China and make it cheaper, a lot more people are going to buy it because it's cheaper, which will result in having more reviews, which will result in moving it to the top of the Amazon page, which results in the people who took huge unethical shortcuts to make the majority of the profit. The way it works is basically someone dreams up an item that they want, they go onto Alibaba, they get it mass produced in very, very, very cheap ways and throw it up on Amazon, leaving people like Stasher Bags, who make their bags to be super high quality, in the dust essentially. Now, not only is this unethical to do when it's a product you're just slapping your name on and you're taking up space in that industry, I personally think that's an ethical issue. You might not, but I do. But you're also making a lower quality product, which in turn means that people will have to repurchase those items, in turn leading to more environmental damage, also leading to the consumer spending more because they are replacing that item because they didn't buy the higher quality, slightly more expensive item up front. But the whole misconception here is that just because something is an eco-friendly material, just because something is reusable, does not make it an ethical item and does not make it, you know, the most sustainable option. When you have a brand who created their product, who manufactures their product, they are aware of the life cycle of that item. Whereas when someone dropships something, they don't really have a say in how the item is produced. The solution here is essentially to make sure that you are purchasing from brands that are reputable, and there are a couple ways to do that. That's actually quite literally my job, so I always recommend following people on the internet who do those things for you, who can evaluate those things for you, and taking them up on what they recommend. And then number two, personally, obviously for people in the US, and hopefully soon outside of the US when they open it up, is to shop on places that verify for you, right? So Earth Hero has a 5-step process. All the information you could ever need on the ethics and sustainability of a product are on their website, which makes it just so easy for you to know if you're making an informed, sustainable decision. Misconception number three is that sustainable things are more expensive just because they know people will pay for it or because it has a special label. I hear this a lot across the internet and in my personal life with like my friends and family who think that things are sustainable are only more expensive because they're marketed as sustainable, or people who think organic is only more expensive because it's marketed as organic, which is so strange. I think probably if you're watching this, a lot of the times you'll know this information, but I think it is important to be prepared to meet those criticisms with the true answer of why sustainable and ethically done things are more expensive. And the whole answer and the whole reason that sustainable things are more expensive is because they're done ethically and sustainably. You see this in the unsustainable brands not taking responsibility for their actions and then offsetting that cost onto the people who live in the environments, the people who make their products, etc. So let me explain what that means. If you take the unsustainable brand over here and the sustainable brand, the reason that something might be more expensive if it's sustainable is the people that are unsustainable, maybe they didn't care about how they discharge their wastewater. Maybe they moved their manufacturing to a country that allows them to discharge toxic things into the water system. But the sustainable brand has taken that into account. And this is an overall way to understand what offsetting means. The sustainable brands take responsibility for their footprint and do something about it. The unsustainable brands do not. They're not mindful of their farming practices and take shortcuts yet again that have impacts on the environment and on the people. The more obvious ones are the people who are unethical businesses don't pay their workers fair wages and take advantage of people in other countries and unsafe working conditions. Sustainable brands do not do that. Many sustainable companies pay money to get certifications to justify the actions that they're doing. Unsustainable brands do not do that. Sustainable brands do life cycle analysis, pay professionals to take a look at the life cycle of their product and make it better in those ways. Unsustainable brands do not do that, and they take shortcuts in all of these places and offset that cost onto the public instead of putting that into the price of an item. And that is why sustainable things are more expensive. It's not just because of a label, it's because of the way things are manufactured. And honestly, it's so frustrating to me that the unsustainable thing have been seen as normal and affordable instead of taking a look at what shortcuts have been taken here and blaming the sustainable things for being expensive. I think it depends on where we set the baseline and what was seen as normal. And it's so frustrating that this was able to be seen as normal first. But I also think that when you pay a higher price for a higher quality item, it's A, going to last longer just in the sense of it being a higher quality item. But two, when you have to pay more for something, you find more value in it. That's just the reality of things. And so when things are made cheaply, it's fine in your mind to not take care of them, to throw them out and to replace them. And I do think it's unfortunate that that disparity creates a space where it seems like living sustainably is more expensive and unachievable for lower socioeconomic status people, but I don't think that we should be exploiting people and our resources and the planet. And again, we come to the point where those three pillars of sustainability have to come together to make sense in ways like the government imposes regulations to make sure that brands are taking on that responsibility and that cost without putting that cost onto the consumer. This is large, huge differences that have to be made in our structure of society in order for it to work. But that's the real solution at its core instead of like stopgap issues. Alrighty guys, well, I hope this video was entertaining, informative, helpful. I hope you appreciate it. I am looking forward to hearing you in the comments and looking forward to furthering this sort of discussion where we get beyond the basics, and that's kind of what I'm here for. Also, if you guys haven't been keeping up with me over on Instagram, or if you didn't see my community tab post, there is some very serious stuff happening in my family right now. I am trying not to be absent. I am trying to work ahead so that maybe I can have things done, but please just be mindful of that as you might be trying to get a hold of me, or if I'm not responding to things, or yeah, if anything like that. Hopefully I'll be able to talk to you about what has happened soon, because I hate saying things like that and then leaving you in the dark. But again, all the proceeds from this video that I make will be going to Campaign Zero. So don't forget to also submit your donations at shellbizzle.com/donate. And don't forget that you cannot do all the good that the world needs, but the world needs all the good that you can do. Bye, guys.